Or they...
Wow. We got some sneezing in the house. Very sneeze. Very sneeze. Very sneeze. Very wow. Very sneeze. I'm just going to tidy up some of the string stuff that we were working on yesterday, and then hopefully we can ship the beta to the people, because there was a bug that we found that somebody else fixed that's pretty important. So anytime we fix something that's like a very high value bug, I like to not wait too long on it. So yeah. What are we using reflection for? Doesn't seem very good. Set value from string. And then get enum by name. It's the only two things we're importing that for. Parse enum. I kind of don't feel like this should be really in the same module as this other stuff. So don't understand parse token. Like, what does that even mean? What the fuck is parse token? This kind of angers me because it's not a fucking token. Somehow I missed the fact that all this stuff was in this file when we were working on it. Like, what does this even do? Let's look at this for a second. So delimiters form single character tokens. What? Okay. I don't like any of this. So if it's a delimiter, otherwise advance until space or delimiter. So it's either one of these one character tokens or it's like an identifier. That's just not like who can. Yeah, okay. I'm not going to worry about this today. But we're going to get rid of this some other time because it's I'm not a fan of what this represents. Not a fan. Not a fan. So this is basically just like what? This is not how you write a parser. It's so the reason why this is not how you write a parser is because like every leaf routine also has this weird delimiters. It's like it's complexifying by passing like this kind of stuff down into the possibility of parsing any individual thing. Whereas when you're parsing a grammar, you notice delimiters like before you call this kind of stuff. It shouldn't go down in here. Nobody calls it though, except a little bit of stuff in Sokoban. Shader GL old is going to go away. Yeah, no, do not write a parser this way. Do not. It's like, this is kind of a way to write a parser so that you're always a little bit confused about what's going on. Don't do it. Did I catch the bug in trim? Probably not. What's the bug? I don't see a bug. Should be trim right whatever comma cares. Oh, because it's using the default otherwise. That's a good point. Thank you. I bet our tests only call this with the default. Yes. Okay. Parse bool, parse enum, parse float, parse int. And then the match token stuff, like, yeah, that's all in shader gl old. So once we delete that, then we're good. There's one or two other uses of that kind of stuff. So Yeah, it's not used at all anywhere else except Sokoban. And it's barely used there. Which is good because it don't do things this way. Well, the match tokens are not is match token no case used? Yes, of course. Okay. Well, it's good that we're phasing out most of the code that calls those functions. Okay, kind of what I'm doing right now is I want to document this stuff at the head of the file. Does the string module have SIMD optimizations? It has a couple. It has a couple. It's going to get more over time, but that was part of what was happening was I wanted to go in here and put some SIMD in here as an example, and saw, like historically, there's been a lot of stuff in here that I don't like, and it's been very messy, and that's not good because you need a good string set of functions. God damn it. I hate the word stir. This is going to seem very silly that I'm about to passive aggressively go through here and rename every stir to S. And it is, kind of, but it's also very important. Oh, fuck. It's kind of, it's one of these weird things where if people who are not good programmers do it, it's like trivial rat holing that's annoying. But if people who are good programmers do it, it's kind of for deep reasons a lot of the time. Like for me, I absolutely hate this abbreviation culture, especially that's invaded C++ and everything is fucking putter or whatever. It drives me nuts. Because when you're reading things, it's like a stuttering, halting mental way of reading things. And it's not conducive to fluid thought. In the way that I program, right? And that may or may not be true for other people. But all I know when I'm making this programming language is that I'm trying to do everything I know to make the code as good as possible, right? And so sometimes that includes stuff like this. It seems stupid, right? That's all. I don't know. I feel like I didn't quite explain that super well. Yeah, this is why I don't want to auto replace it because I'll make mistakes like this. I swear I'm going to break something doing this too. Like I'm going to forget, like there, if I had forgotten to replace this S with a T, it would have made the function wrong, and that's very dangerous. But I'm still going to fucking do it because this drives me up the fucking wall. Like the line must be drawn here sometimes, you know? Even if it looks stupid, like I'm fighting against something that's actually very big and very pervasive. And I'm going to do what I can against it. Make sure there wasn't an S in there. Hopefully, somebody out there knows what I'm saying. Replace S with T first. Yeah, I was thinking that. Sort of a two-pass algorithm. Hopefully. So I changed a bunch of those before, but so what I could do right now I'm just going to do some tests right now. So if we break something, then see, this is an easy break. Like if it doesn't compile, then that's easy, right? But like if it doesn't run, that's bad. Then we have to debug. Some late streams. Yeah, it's like after I do the day's work, then I come stream sometimes. Asm x86 broke, but I think that's just because I didn't recompile the compiler after updating. Yeah, I didn't. And he probably changed some stuff there. So let's actually. Okay, we're running it, so here we go. Mr. Feast Raid. I could use a feast right now. Do you guys bring feasts with you? I could use a feast. I want like a turkey leg and a tankard of mead. Welcome, everybody. It's Adam Plays. Well, this is almost like that time we got raided by PewDiePie. What's up, people? How's it going, everybody? I don't know how many people are in the raid, but it looks like it's at least 200, so that's cool. Does it say? Let me scroll up. 176, that's great. Hello. Hello, 176 people. He has a channel on YouTube called YMS. Okay. Well, that's great. We are programming tonight. I don't know if that's exciting to people. We're working on compilers. We're not working on video games. We're running a video game once in a while as a test, but actually, you know what? Shall we do a Benny test for all the new people? Is that a good way to initiate people to the channel? I think that's a good initiation to the channel. So give me about 30 seconds to build this, and we'll do a Benny test. Yesterday's stream got partially muted. Well, then maybe today's stream is going to get partially muted as well. Here we go. Takes us a while to make a release build. All right, whoops, I'm typing in the wrong window. Here we go. Glad you like the game. We work very hard on these games, so when people like them, it's important. It's meaningful to us, for sure. I still have the rule where I fix one level per Benny test. I'm going to suspend that rule right now because I want to get this other stuff done before bed. That should be the rule, though. I'm just not going to do it. So some of these levels have complete programmer art with a bunch of cubes, but once in a while you'll see one with really nice graphics, and those are the ones that are closer to done. I mean, it seems like things are working, but we'll let the test run out to conclusion. The art team is running somewhat independently to work on the levels, but we meet once in a while to sort of coordinate. But I have too much going on to like micromanage the art team, right? Like I have to stream and run Benny tests. How do I feel development went? It's been going pretty well. It's just, it's always hard to make a programming language and then an engine in the programming language and then a game in the engine. Like that's just always a lot of work. So, but I signed up for it and it's going great. Like the game is going to be really good. So, yeah. Programming language. I mean, it's like making anything else. It's a program that compiles the programming language. Cool mechanic with fire. I mean, it's like anything else. It's a gameplay element that is used as effectively as we can when we can. Why did I run this in the background? Because I'm having fun watching it and I'm showing it to the people. This guy's stuck in a rock hole. Kind of section style puzzle game. It was just the game idea, right? I had an idea to do something and I was like, oh, that'll be really cool. Yeah, this is, I don't want to like totally spoiler why. There's a very significant reason. My MFG was almost working. No, we didn't change the recording, but might have fixed some of the, well, I don't know why it would. Alright, I'm gonna let the music go, even though we finished the playback. That was all the levels currently in the game. We have 756 total. Spend learning things about the powers and how they work. I mean, I learned a lot of that a long time ago when I was in college, and it was like on my own time because I didn't ever go to class. It's hard to do.
Telling the truth can be bad news.
Telling the truth can be bad news.
Telling the truth can be
telling the truth can be good news.
Telling the truth is a bad idea.
Telling the truth is a difficult problem.
Telling the truth is a scary predicament.
Telling the truth is a bitter herb.
Telling the truth is a dangerous tunnel.
When you get out of that tunnel,
oh, we were doing the stirs.
Life ahead. Forget herb. I never heard of a hit that had the word herb in it.
Telling the truth is a dangerous
thing.
Dangerous.
Telling the truth can be dangerous.
What?
Tell.
Danger. Telling the truth can be danger.
I'm just passive aggressively replacing all the stirs with S's.
Telling the truth can be dangerous business.
Why?
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 Why? Telling the truth can be dangerous business. Because if yourself, because you don't know why.
Huh?
Well, I'm just giving you what the idea is.
Oh, these are deprecated. I don't care about the deprecated. So that actually means we finished.
You don't know why.
That's great.
Oh, is that brilliant?
Telling the truth can be dangerous business. Honest and popular don't go hand in hand. If you admit that you can play the accordion, no one will hire you in a rock and roll band. But we can't sing,
can sing
our hearts out. If we're lucky, we'll no neighbors complain.
All right. That end of music time. We had very good music time. Have a good night. Thanks for coming by. Thanks for coming by. We're documenting. Here. We're documenting the functions. I'm putting the names first. We'll just put all this documentation at the front. You know what? And we should only have one copy, so. Okay, scan two. And like, okay, so the scan stuff and wildcard match, I feel like that should all be. Like not even a thing. Okay. Okay. Hold on. Wildcard stuff will be at the bottom since that's like the most complicated. I really need to come up with a better name than Slice that I like. I mean, I kind of like view, but it's also a little too generic of a word. But maybe that's fine. Now see, all these splits and stuff, these should be frickin' up here. Okay. That's fine for now. So now I just have to say enough things about this to bring the value to the people. Okay. Suffix.count. For any bytes in S also contained in chars, overwrite those bytes with replacement. This modifies S destructively in place. If it's S is in read-only memory, this will work. Okay. Each occurrence of old inside S is replaced by new. Boy, I could use some Bengal spice. Slice is just as generic, maybe. Maybe that's true. Return a new string. We have to say where the string, if you have to free it or not. Replacement scans from left to right. Does not consider overlaps. Like really, eventually we want much more thorough documentation for each of these. Like this will do it for now. Split S by old. The resulting string is allocated with alloc. Okay. And so well, I don't know if you want to free it. Like, what a fucking poopy way to write this. I mean, it's the high-level modern programmer way of doing it, but, like, you just shouldn't do that for stuff like this. What to lower is this calling? Is it here? Yeah. This is also we should specify does not modify non uppercase characters, those from A to Z, only modifies. Like, that's better than a double negative, right? Only modifies lowercase characters. Like, these are just things that there might be uncertainty about that you need to tell people. Return a string view index count characters long. I don't like the name slice because it sounds like a modification operation. So we will probably change the name of this. Join. Make a string consisting of each member of inputs with separator sandwiched in between. For example, if inputs is 1, 2, 3, we could put that in line and a separator is colon, the result, if before first is one, two, three. Okay. We should make it a more than one character separator, just so that people know. I don't know. That's a little weird. What's a good separator? Interval. Interval's kind of long. I mean, I thought about like substring. So the thing is, okay, substring is too specific to strings because you want a word that'll apply to arrays as well. Comma. Comma's only one character. Yeah, we'll do colon, colon. That's fine. It looks like C++, so people will take it seriously. I'm missing a what? Oh, yes. There we go. Sub view? Maybe, but then maybe view is fine on that. Segment kind of sounds like a verb, kind of like slice does. Okay, I would start some Bengal spice water going, and then we will return. And I will do even more. The thing about adding all these comments is people will compile them every time they compile. So we're going to want to make sure that we go real fast through comments. It kind of pains me, actually, thinking about all the work once this language is very popular and trillions of people around the world use this programming language. They're all going to be compiling this comment, and like every single time, the compiler will doing extra work. That said, it'll be way less extra work than when they compile C++, so whatever. Got a fruit bar, that's the real brain power. Maybe it should be separated into a README, maybe. Yeah, that's quite possible, but one step at a time. Let's at least put any information at all. When can you make a game? You can make a game right now. In C++. Am I putting semicolons on these? Yeah. Okay. It's hard to explain these things. If a match is found, if no match is found, return minus one. If a match is found, oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Was a witness developed in C++ and not C, because that is what we did. Do do and do, do do do, do do and do, do do do, Do-do-do-do. Telling the truth can be bad news. Telling the truth can be good news. Okay. This can go down with the trims. Okay. So this is a byte. You turn the index in S where byte was found. If no match. Like find index from left, but starting at the right and proceeding leftward. Is three. Like, just if documentation had examples, generally, it would be so much better. If that C++ was getting easier, no. C++ is not getting easier. Came here discovering the bug you were hunting for 3 days was a use after free. Woof. I bet you're programming on Linux, aren't you? Because on Visual Studio, use after free is very easy to find, probably. Not always, I guess, but usually. In the standard library, there's no real standard library, but in the library we ship with this compiler, we ship with a memory debugger now that'll tell you, it'll just tell you if you do use after free, if you turn it on. It just comes by default. It's very easy to use. Okay. Now, to be fair, I don't think I'm actually putting enough information in this documentation, but my goal is to ship it tonight. So it's more than there used to be. Okay. So we're gonna do this down here. We're going to say, like the byte version of find index from left, but searching for an entire string instead of a byte. In practice, this will be slower than the byte version. So if you are searching for a single byte, either, well, we'll just say this. Okay. Find index from any, from left. Like the byte version of find index from left, but single byte, returns a match when any of the bytes in bytes are found. Be careful, because this takes the same argument types as the string version of find index from left. So calling the wrong routine would be an easy mistake to make. Okay. We should do an example for this one. So for example, find index of any from left of Chattanooga with X, whatever, TO is equal to three. Like the bytes version of find index of any from left, but starting from the right. So this would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8. You know what we're going to do? We're going to put these in the test function as a way of ratifying that the documentation is correct. Okay. And then we're going to run it. Whoops, this is supposed to say from right. Typo. All right. So we're running it three times because the metaprogram, the main program, and then maybe even default metaprogram? I don't, probably. Anyway, it didn't assert, so that's fine. It means it works. Am I concerned about implementation diverging from the comments? Yes, that is always a concern. But that shouldn't stop you from informing people. Why are these functions named left, right, as opposed to start, end? I wrote that in the comment that we're probably going to change it later. It's just, I don't want to change it right now because I have too much to think about and I'm compartmentalizing the changes. I don't want to rename fucking everything. I want to ship this to the people tonight and we'll change it later. Like, we already have made a lot of big changes basically to this code. So yeah, there is this weird issue about right to left languages being confused, and that's why this is not good terminology. We know that. But it's just, one thing that I've learned about shipping things is that don't let your problem become too big at any one time. If you keep letting things balloon and balloon and balloon and don't like contain them, that's how you fail to make progress and fail to ship. So I've made a lot of improvements in this module, and we're going to ship it and then we'll make more improvements later. that is the reasoning. Okay. Split from left, split from right. Using the same index returned by split S into two strings, left and right, which contains all of S before the byte and which contains all of S after the byte. The particular occurrence of byte will not be presented in either left or right, will not be contained in either left or right, but but that byte may be other instances of that byte value may be contained in write. Example, split from left of by this character is equal to yields found equals true, left equals like this is weird because let's just do this. True. I should use something. I shouldn't use this example. I should use something with multiples. How about using macro backtick syntax to have a single line? Yeah, we don't really have that kind of convention yet. We probably should. Like, maybe we just write all these in Markdown or something, right? That might be smart because Markdown is like actually readable. I'm not trying to make the task too big tonight. Yeah, the problem is I want something that's different from the right. So Slaughterhouse-5 is not actually, unless I split by E or something, but If no match is found, the return value is false. S right, is that right? Yeah. I need to think of a better example. Like split from spilt milk. Like split from left, but All right, let's verify that. Split by space. I wanted maybe something a little more visible, but maybe space is fine. Here. Okay, so split from right, instead of yields, let's say returns. The returned strings are just views into S, so no allocation occurs. When will it come out? I don't know. We're working on it. It's been taking longer than I wish it did. What of the last character is separator? What if the last character is separator? You'll get an empty string, which is fine. That's like, I sort of feel like it's not worth saying that for now. Yeah. I wish I could do everything instantly. Yeah. Okay, split from left by any, split from right by any. Okay, like the byte version of split from left, but splitting by an entire string, splitting by a substring. What did I say up here? We'll say generally this will be slower than the byte version. If I could do everything instantly, would it be worth doing? Yes. Yes, it would be worth doing. Too bad I couldn't make an August 6th, I think you mean. But, oh, wait, you mean August 9th. I don't know why. Okay. Don't tempt me. We could always delay it till next August. Wait, is 12 Minutes actually released? I thought it was still coming soon. Oh, that's when, okay. Okay. Should be released today, really? Let's see. Let's see if it's on Steam. We won't play it tonight because I'm working, but, you know. 12 Minutes. It's actually out. No, it's out tomorrow. Okay. So, like, probably, maybe you're in a different place where it's tomorrow. I also, though, there was another game I saw a trailer for. That is out today. And we're, of course, going to have to play this one. Okay, but we're not going to play them now. Temple of Snek. I do not have Game Pass. This is not a recommendation. I have not played Temple of Snek. It is, however, I saw the trailer and I was like, all right, I'll play it. You know what I'm saying? All right, let's close this because we're not playing games right now. We're not playing Project Cars. Okay. Should I do examples for all these? Probably, right? I should just be consistent and do them. Let me just. Okay. Okay, so split from left with a substring. What's a good substring? No, because we want something that's going to come out differently for left and right again. I think it's always good when people get to play a game that's a new discovery. Okay. My imagination brain is not really activating. Yes. I'm thinking of something like that has ands in it, right? And then we could do a fun example. Split from left by any, A and B and C by, let's say, apple and banana and cake by and. Returns true, apple, banana, and cake, right? We could put the spaces in the and, but I kind of want who told you that cake is unhealthy? Who says cake is unhealthy? I think that's absurd. Split S at all occurrences of separator. Returning an array of result strings, separator can be either of type U8 or string. It's, yeah. It's like maybe, like if I'm doing that down here, maybe I should do that up here. I don't know. Split apple and banana and cake and returns apple, banana, cake. Why am I? The strings are just views on S. The returned strings are, so they do not incur allocations. The array data for result is allocated via temporary storage. Okay. Oh my God, there's so many things to comment about. Oh my gosh. Trim left, trim right, trim. I mean, we're actually not doing too badly. Okay, so this new experiment one was scan two. I just wanted to come down here for a bit to make progress, to make rapid like I'm kind of squeezing from the bottom up. I think everything down here is fine. Everything here is fine. So we do wildcard match. We're actually not that. Not doing that bad. So we have these to document. That's not bad. Oh, and this can just be here. Okay, great. So we need to document these and these nuggets. Split by any. Wait, what? Wrong explanation. Where? Oh. Wow. I totally, yeah, no, you're right. Wrong example, you mean. Yeah, okay. That example is for the, oh, right, because I wanted to go back and do, remember I got ahead of myself and wanted to go back and do examples here, and then I forgot to do the examples. So we want this. And this, these are the string versions. Okay, so now we just need to come up with examples for these. Apple and banana and cake is not really that good. Thanks for noticing that. What do I do here? Yeah, this is so much documentation, and it should be much bigger. We probably should move this to a markdown file. And then we could sort of link to it from here. Maybe that should be the convention. And then also, maybe there can be a comment that do markdown files have like search tags and stuff? Because we could tag the function with a comment that goes into the markdown file, which would be a much better form of so-called autodoc than regular autodoc systems, right? Because then you could be like debugging or stepping through the code or whatever, and then like click on the link. Should add the error properly with the and banana and cake. Let's do that. That's kind of funny. I don't know if that's the best example if you're learning. But it'll bring case sensitivity into it and all that. So A, N, and D will go apple, comma, and banana and cake, right? And then split. Okay, I like that. Apple and banana and cake returns. Okay, so this part is not that good because we're matching on A both of the times because cake happens to have an A, but that's fine. Markdown doesn't have anything like that. Typoed apple and banana. That is not a typo. That is not a typo. Oh, in the second one it is. Yes, sorry. Okay, so what I get for pasting it. Okay, great. Trim left. The returned string is just a view on S, so no occurs. This should be called bytes. Okay. Trim left. How do you describe it without just saying trim left? Start scanning from left to right, removing all characters in S that are contained, all bytes in S contained in chars, as soon as a non-matching byte is found, stop and return the rest of the string. Example, trim left of Okay. What's a good example here? To rim left. Maybe change to make bytes U8. It's just easier to pass it as a string. It's more convenient, although that would reduce the problem of calling the wrong thing. It is much less convenient, so I'm not sure how to figure that out. Donuts. Like, okay, we could trim spaces off things. I don't know. I'm just thinking of putting something weird like that's a little bit of a weird to read example. It's where my brain went, you know? It's where my brain went. Can you do and dot data? No, that is a pointer, not an array. I just didn't think of a better example than this for beginners. Like, usually what you want to do is trim spaces or whatever. But that, if you see like slash n, backslash n, backslash r, backslash 9, backslash t, or whatever. It's like, what? What is that? I don't know. This is kind of the inverse of trim. scanning from left to right. When any of the bytes in bytes is detected, stop and return the contents of S up to that point. So I'm running out of imagination brain ideas. Hit F5 on brain. Stop at any. What is our example? Trim right example is calling trim left. Dang it. That's not good. Okay. Stop at any. Of I don't know, something. No, let's not put the word. That's just we're not trying that hard. Stop at any the art of computer programming. That's actually not that good of an example. What's a good book? How about permutations that's actually not that good either. I want something cuter than that. We're switching the books up. We're going Gravity's Rainbow by B, C, D, E, F, G, H, returns Gravity's Rain. Right? Did I screw that up? I don't think so. B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay. What? There's another raid. Okay, you're banned for saying Dragon Book. Welcome, people. What's going on? I'm getting tired, but we still have more things to document. How hard would it be to make a metaprogram generate the examples and also put them in tests? I don't think I would want a metaprogram to generate the examples, because the examples are documentation, right? You want them to be picked by a human being. But like somehow detecting them, or maybe we mark them in here and putting them in tests, that would be not that hard, except this is all in a comment. So the metaprogram would have to like read the file separately. Like, you don't get information on comments through compiler messages, but you could just read the file. And then that would be a good way to, again, ensure that the documentation is correct. So some of these typos that I made, right, if you were automatically generating tests for these, you would catch those. Oh, but good documentation is actually so nice. Don't you wish you had good documentation when you program? We're almost done. We just have these, and everybody knows about paths, right? Everybody knows about paths. Separate the file path name into its components. Just do an example for this. I'm getting tired. Example, path decomp of home wizard frobs.z. I actually don't remember if we return if the extension has the period. Path extension, right? Okay, so it's after, it doesn't contain the period. Returns home wizard, I think. We're going to want to test this. Resrov foo resrov.foo. The returned strings are just views on paths, so no allocation is performed. Path decomp calls the path routines below to generate the various results, so refer to them for details. Incomplete. We should document here what happens with dot dot kinds of things and various corner cases in the code. Okay, let's test this before I get too fancy pants. I took out my run, didn't I? Where's my Chattanoogas? A, B, C, D are this. We're gonna assert A is this. Assert B is this. Assert C is that. Assert D is that. Okay. Run print testing. We'll just leave it up and put a no check in here. Uh-oh. It didn't like that. It's B. Really? Or maybe it's this one and I got... let me just see. Home wizard Rezrov dot. I screwed it up, guys. That is clearly wrong. We caught a bug while writing documentation, bro. Okay. Path decomp. Name, base name. If extension, No, this is supposed to catch this. Okay, if there is a dot at the end of the file name, path extension returns the empty string. But so I rewrote this a couple weeks ago, and I guess nobody uses the base name return value yet. So we want to remove that. But we also want to remove it with a non-empty extension. So we just remove extension.count plus one. Okay. So I hope that's right. We shouldn't do that. Okay. Let's do this. We do this, and then we go, if extension is not equal to this, or base name yes, okay. There we go. Totally works. Never was a problem, guys. I don't know who said there was a problem. There's no evidence of any problem. And just like the vaccine people say, if there's no evidence, that means there's no problem. All right. What was the ridiculous news article that I read? It was something from the American Pediatric Association where they said, there's no evidence. Oh, it was, there's no evidence that wearing masks all day, every day will stunt your child's development at recognizing faces and stuff. There are no studies proving this. Therefore, wearing masks will not stunt your child's development. It was like the most absurd thing. You thought I went for full words like decompose? I usually do. The reason I didn't do it just in this one case is because of the tradition of matrix decomp functions being called decomp. It's like, I know why it seems a little bit inconsistent. I'm not sure this is going to be the final name. It's fine for now. Yeah, I was so angry at that because it's child abuse. Like, it's institutionalized child abuse. Just comment, you know this stuff, everybody does. What about the summer intern? Think of the summer intern. Think of the summer intern. I actually don't know what this returns. Yeah, okay. It's the file name with extension. We should verify that that slash is there, but I think it is. Why did I put the dot there? That's not right. Okay, let's verify some of these. Path strip extension, path extension. We're just making sure that there's no bugs and that, like, when I say there's not a dot or there is a slash, that those are the case. Wait, no, I commented it out. We'll leave this on. Hey, it works. Great. Oh, we can take out this print here. This DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. All right. The resrov.foo, I wish I had imagination right now for a better example, but that's okay. Okay, path overwrite separators. Modify path in place to convert one kind of directory separator to another. Ensure. Wait, no? Why is it called over? Hold on. Why does it return a thing? Don't do that. Don't. Okay. Okay. Okay, ensure path is writable or you will have a sad time. Example. See, this is going to be confusing because it's backslashed. Like, just say what it's really for. This is another thing that documentation often does, is like something will be written for a particular purpose, but they'll like pretend like that's not really what it's for, right? They'll like passive aggressively just describe the functionality and not why the functionality, and that loses knowledge, right? You want to convey that knowledge. You don't want to lose that knowledge. In the string literal, but in memory, there is only one backslash. But as the string is represented in memory, there is only one backslash at each of those locations. You gotta think of the summer in term. Gotta think of the summer in term. Is absolute path. Oh my God, is it the last one? If path starts at the root of starts with slash or backslash. I mean, again, that's confusing, but okay. Or a drive letter for Windows, return true, otherwise return false. I don't know. Okay, that's enough for now. We have done a heroic effort tonight. We have written 400 lines of documentation. The whole file is 1,500 lines, so like almost a third of the file is now documentation. I do think that means maybe we should move it to like frickin' Markdown or something, but okay, let's run the test. And then Ryan fixed a important bug to fix. Uh-oh. Wait. I thought our theory was that was failing because I hadn't rebuilt the compiler. But I did. And now it's still failing. But maybe it's because I messed something else up. Okay. Oh, because I changed path overwrite separators. I hate this. This is not okay. This is written this way to support this kind of a thing. I hate that. Like this kind of like do a complex operation as a parameter. Just do it before the call. Just do the assignment. Do it before the call. Because here there are two pieces of complexity. There's this doing this heavily side effecty thing as a parameter, which should probably be a separate step. And there's making this function return the same argument that it's operating on, which is just confusing. Because you look at it, you're like, is that a different? What is that, right? So the line must be drawn here. We're gonna change this. All right. So path overwrite separators. So we're gonna do this. Like, I'm sorry, that's just better. That is simply better. Bite me. All right. I have a small C. I have a small C. What? Oh, see, that's not what it returns. That is not what it returns. All right. Path overwrite separators in build CPP. See, that one's using it right. Here, yeah, don't do this. It's just confusing. Just do the steps. Do the steps that are happening in the order that they happen. Don't do this trying to pack lots of stuff into parameters. It'll just make you sad. It's like there's this like fake economy where it feels more sleek sometimes to do that. But then you just go editing the code and you want to put something between those times or whatever, and you have to break it out anyway. Just break it out. Just break it out. Oh, that's not the only time this happened. Here we go. What is all this? Is this like the same code over and over? What the fuck am I looking at? How is Babby formed right now? Warning, this code looks like it has a lot of relatively low quality copy pasta inside. Use at your own risk. Maybe we will clean it up later. Like what? Like how many times are you gonna do this? All right. Isn't the function supposed to return a string? It did return a string, but I thought that was not a good design for the function, so I changed it. And that broke people who were using the return value. Can you implement path separators using the other functions? There is one, there is a replace string function, but it is more expensive because it makes an array of sub elements and then reconcatenates them. So it's just better to have an in place one sometimes. I don't know. This is not code from the new program. This is code that was written years ago by someone else. No, the both people working on the compiler now are doing a good job. Happy with it. It's going great. Compiler is making really good progress right now. Really good. It's making such good progress. Here, let's run a x64 tests, and let's go to basic examples and memory debugger. This was broken, and I believe Ryan fixed it. So memory debugger, right? So that works. That always worked. So this is saying, hey, here are your leaks, and then there's some examples in there where you can do a freeing freed memory and stuff, and it'll detect it. Okay, memory debugger dash release. This did not work before, and now it will. Yeah, and this is fine that we're not returning the thing. Now, if I go to the default metaprogram, I'm just going to hack this so that when you pass release, we don't do this. And I just want to see it run in release with a stack trace. Like, you could set up your own metaprogram as well, but you see it's giving all the good information, even though it's a release build, because this stack trace is actually built into your program by the compiler. So it doesn't depend on the details of your operating system. It's the same everywhere. Wonderful. Okay. So good. All right. So I think I commit this. Comment modules string a bit. Okay, did we change SokoBan? No. Okay. Oh, it's 12 a.m. It's tomorrow. Dang it. All right. So we're going to go. Let's go to the change log because this has some weird notes. We did this. And this is going to go into to do. Okay. All right. So we're going to say update the version number for the beta. Bam. How hard was the memory debugger? It was pretty easy. I think I lied before. It doesn't detect use after free. It detects freeing free. It detects freeing something from the wrong allocator than what you allocated it from and that kind of stuff. Use after free, we do the same thing that the Visual Studio standard library does, where you can turn on a thing that just fills the memory with a known pattern that'll, like, you know, mess your program up in a way that is detectable, right? Or visually. People who program in Windows know what I'm talking about. Longer term, I do want to do some kind of thread sanitizer or address sanitizer kind of work. Yeah, the CC and CD stuff, exactly. That is exactly what I am talking about. But if you do like thread sanitizer and address sanitizer type stuff, or, you know, model it after Purify or whatever, then you can detect use after free. And so I want to put that in the standard library. I was just getting mixed up when I said we did that before. Okay, I'm running Ubuntu here. And I'm going to update. taking its time. Oh no, we're downloading a new LLVM. Downloading a new LLVM. Isn't the example wrong then? The example for, you're talking about the returning a thing? Hold on. Path overwrite separators. Oh, this part is wrong. Right there. Yes, and it doesn't return. It says modifies path to contain this. Yes, okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay, we could put examples to the two lower and all that kind of thing, but I don't want to do that right now. Okay, we're good. We're good. How's... I got an email saying brand collaboration, exclamation point. I'm sorry. I don't want to do a brand collaboration. That is not... not what I'm into. Okay. We're building on the Linux. Oh no! All right. So there's some go-tos. That Clang does not like, that Ryan did. You can't go to pass the variable initialization in C++, because C++ was, the rules were written by people who don't want you to successfully program. So now I have to try to fix this on Linux here. Well, in WSL, where you cannot even see what I'm doing. So that's great. Sponsored by Doritos. Okay, line 1811 and 1784. Go to resource allocated. Cannot move this down to its assignment site because Clang will complain about the go-to skipping it. Colon, break declaration from assignment. And I'll put a note down here that that's what that is. Okay, that doesn't look too bad. Let's see if it only complains about the other one now. Yeah, so 1812. Same thing. It looks like copy pasta code. Why is this... Oh, it's a different loop, actually. It's just very similar in structure. Okay, so same thing. I have a go-to, and we're just going to go. See the note above about this, and... And line info. Okay, how's that? Yeah, it's compiling now. Oh no, there's a crab. There's a crab. We must flee from the crabs. Somebody asked me about if we were hiring for the compiler team on Twitter or something. And I said no, because we did get two people on it so far, and that's going well. So we don't have openings there. But like, he had the crab in his name on Twitter. And I was like, okay. I'm going to commit this file and say modify some declarations to make Clang not grumpy, to make Clang deign to permit us to do a goto. To use goto. Okay. So I'm checking the version number on the executable. That is correct. We're going to make the tests. They are running. Yeah, I don't know why all these people want to advertise that they have crabs, right? It doesn't make that much sense to me, but maybe they know. I know, like, if you have crabs, but you want to find someone to get with, right? If that other person also has crabs, then, like, there's less to worry about. So I think it's, like, something like that, right? People are advertising which sector of the dating market that they're in. Update Linux binary. All right. Now, I don't know. I still don't have our... We have this server that's like a beefy Threadripper now, but I haven't turned up the test... The build server to use all the cores yet. It just uses like two. So it might not have finished doing all the tests and stuff. We'll see. Is there still a Rust team at Mozilla? Or whatever it's called? I thought... Didn't they decommission like half the company? Or is Rust team still in there? So 16274. Really? Okay. Well, it's still much faster than the old thing was. All right. All right. So... Boom. Let's make it happen. They had organized a walkout. This was a few months after they fired a ton of people. Time flies. I feel like that was relatively recent, but I guess it was a while ago. They got adapted by Amazon or moved. You have a program of 24,000 lines of code. You have a laptop from 2015 with an APU running 1 to 2 gigahertz. You have a desktop with a Ryzen 5 with O2. It takes 3 minutes to compile on the desktop and 2 minutes and 45 seconds on the laptop. I assume that's a C++ program, right? Welcome to C++. archive is 490 megs. No, it should be about 200 megs. It's 200 compressed. Oh, I see. You were looking at this one. What's in it? I mean, there's some bitmaps. There's some binaries. You know, there's like some libraries and stuff. I don't know. I don't know what's in there. I only ship it to the people, and then the people see what's in there. This is Beta 07 Niner. Okay, I am going to turn off my screen for a second while I email people. And I'm going to ship the beta to the people. Right? Right. So I'm going to go. To my email, I'm gonna go, whoa, my Gmail interface changed. It's not any better, they just changed stuff and moved it around. They didn't do anything important. All right, to beta. New compiler beta. I wasn't expecting to ship a beta today, but it was great. It was great to have this bug fix. All right, bam. This beta fixes an inline assembly a problem where the LVM backend was optimizing away inline assembly that had side effects in some cases. We recommend this caused some procedures like atomic swap not to work in release build. We recommend updating to this beta if you use release builds at all. Okay. I'm just telling the people this. I'm telling the people. I really should say that here too, separately. Fixed ASM being optimized away sometimes by the LVM backend. It's kind of major. It's kind of major. Put that there. And I gotta paste the link to the people. Boom. Did I remember to use BCC? No, I didn't. BCC. I caught it before I sent 103 people, 108 people, all their email addresses. Well, we have a 12-minute stream tomorrow. That seems like a very short stream to do. Okay. I feel like it can't possibly be this smooth, but I'm clicking the button. There we go. I've clicked the button. Now we return you to our regularly scheduled programming. And it's pretty much bedtime for me. I feel like it's a little past my bedtime. Can I elaborate on what design for good programmers means? What I mean is the following thing. When you ask about why certain languages are the way they are, you'll get a lot of answers like, well, this is to protect people from making a certain class of mistake or whatever. That's a dumb mistake, right? Or this is to prevent people who write low quality code from ruining the rest of the code or whatever, right? And you can do that, but there's a general thing in the world, broadly speaking, that when you add lots of processes and encumbrance on to enforce a minimum level of quality, you usually also filter out the high levels of quality and you like force things into the middle, right? And I think that's what most of these languages have been doing, is like they do sort of prevent the lowest quality thing from happening, but they also prevent the highest quality thing from happening. So we try not to do that, is what I mean by that. Okay. Thank you, everybody. We shipped the value to the people. I hope they appreciate it. Let me start a new changelog entry for other people working on the compiler. Start a new changelog entry. Things are going well on the, I'm happy with how things are going. It's nice. It's nice. Thanks everybody. See you later. Thanks for the raids. If anyone from those is still around, thanks for hanging out. Maybe next time we'll do more programming and less documentation, but documentation is good. It's good for the people. See ya.